Welcome back, everybody. This time we are coming to you from Northern California, Emigrant Gap to be exact. This is the Snowflower RV Park, which is part of the Thousand Trails Company. And yes, this is an ATV-friendly campground. So sit back and enjoy the ride as we explore around and in the Snowflower campground. Still in the campground, as you might have just saw by that sign, it's 5 mph speed limit. So for this part of the video, I decided to hyperspeed us through it so we didn't lose any of the scenery and the views. I know the four-wheeler sound all crazy and everything, but I'm gonna kind of do this periodically throughout the video because this is such a long video. But here shortly we are going to actually technically be leaving the campground and right here, so sit back and enjoy the ride. Leading to get us through the campground because my Can-Am has a speedometer and the hubby's Kodiak doesn't. So when we have to watch our speed, I usually lead. So at this point, I just pulled over so I could let him lead and figure out where we were going. Again, for the duration of this video, things are slightly sped up. We were not going quite this fast, but it's just enough speed to make the four-wheeler sound normal and not make you too motion sick, but enough to trim down the length of the video. So, just wanted to let you guys know. The trails were a lot rockier than I expected them to be, but I guess that's what happens when you're up in the mountains of California, Northern California. We were at over 5,000 feet in elevation and trying to get up to a lookout that we were told about that was at over 6,000 feet. Me. I don't know if you guys have ever really seen a whole lot of me without the helmet on. Anyways, yeah, we didn't wear the helmets this trip. We were just exploring around the campground, which was kind of unusual because we're used to being able to talk to each other and we couldn't. So get prepared. I talked to the GoPro quite a bit on these next couple videos. like I said earlier, we were trying to get up to that peak. It was supposed to have some really awesome views, but we will come back and visit that trail in our next video, so stay tuned for that. So again, we weren't wearing our helmets, so therefore no communication system, so we were having to yell at each other, and apparently the husband spotted a huge freaking deer with a huge rack. I missed it. I panned the GoPro to see if maybe I caught it on that, but unfortunately I didn't, unless you guys saw it and I didn't, but yeah, apparently it was huge. I look so thrilled, don't I? I guess that's what they must mean by arresting Bitchface. we made it up to the point that we were trying to get to, and as you can tell, there are some amazing views up here. So I don't know if you could tell in that picture of me and the hubby, but there was a lake that we could see off in the distance, so we're gonna head back down and take another side trail and see if we can get some better views. See? I told you I was gonna talk to the GoPro more. Down that trail and it dead ended, so we turned around and this is us coming back up and taking a different trail. Don't know if you could see, but as you can tell now, we are coming up on a side-by-side that was coming up the trail as we were coming down, and yeah, it's not gonna fit for us to pass each other, so he actually found this open area and backed up into it so we could get around him. So the gentleman we passed back there on the side-by-side, this is his camping setup. I guess he's out for the weekend hunting. Here we are bordering another lake that is on a main road. Of course, it's dirt. But there's another lake with a camping area down here. So we are going to head back towards our campground. And again, I zoomed it up. So we didn't miss any of the scenery, but you know, it's not going to take 20 minutes for us to get back. So sit back, enjoy the ride as we hyperspeed again back towards our campground. Seeing it when we were in the truck, but I never did, so I let him lead. obviously. We ended up at another dead end and had to turn around, so we're heading back. I think we were supposed to take the left before that gravel hump. So, yep, we're heading back. So, obviously, we were supposed to turn right back there in the field, but I was just following tracks that I had seen, so, again, I led us into a dead end. we knew we were on the right track this time because the couple from the campground had told us that there was these ridges or humps that we had to go around that they had taken on their way out. So we knew we were on the right track going back. So we are back in the campground now. This is the main road going through the campground from the office into the actual campground. If we would have turned right, it would have taken us to the bottom part of the campground, which is called the cliffs, and up to where we were parked. The road that we took out at the beginning of the video loops around and connects to the upper part of the campground where there are more campsites. This is a cut-through road to get to that area. Right before we turned, that was another section of campground that is apparently private, not part of Thousand Trails. And now we're continuing up to where the tent sites are, and another section of the Thousand Trails campground, and another private section. Now that we've taken our tour of both the private and part of Thousand Trails campgrounds, we're going to continue straight up this trail right here to another overlook that is only accessible through the campgrounds. Okay, so we made it to Vista View, and the elevation up here is 6,150 feet. So the back road back down to the campground and to the main office. road right there to the left is the cut through road that we were just on and looped around. And right there to the right is where we came out of the woods and back into the campground. So now you guys see why I've been speeding things up, because if I would have left this original speed, you guys would have been on a 3-hour tour with us, ATV style, and I don't think you would have enjoyed it as much. Hopefully you have enjoyed this video, but we are heading up to the dam and gonna give you a little bit more of a tour of the campground. The building we just passed on the right is an old ski lodge that they have made into part of the campground, but we will show you in a few minutes where the ski lifts are. But right now we're gonna go overlook the dam. So we are almost back to the camper, which means this will be the end of our video. As always, thank you for watching, and we hope you enjoyed it. Join us on our next video where we do even more exploring around Snowflower RV Resort.